the Sonic Volcano, as they were called, very early on, John and Roger. I mean, it's funny, I think I took it for granted at the time, but they were brilliant, I've got to say. I mean, Roger still is. Roger's probably playing better than ever now. But certainly Roger and Deakey together were such an immensely powerful block to build on. Nobody can quite do it the same, you know. You know, we were boys. I don't know where we learned all this stuff, but they became just inimitable, both of them. John particularly had a very lyrical style and was able to do things which people had never thought of doing, particularly a lot of his high notes working in there. Very, very tuneful, very lyrical, but also absolutely locked in with Roger, really sounding enormous when it needed to be. And Roger, of course, has a unique style. I mean, Roger is one of the world's greatest drummers. He would be embarrassed to hear me say this, probably, but without a doubt, he is. And he's one of the very few drummers that you can hear and know who it is. Drummers tend to, you know, to an extent, you know, do the same things as each other. But Roger has so many little trademarks. I mean, I remember when I first heard him, I was quite amazed. And I thought, well, is this what a real drummer does, you know?
One of my trademarks is... one of my trademarks. It's a backbeat thing, I suppose. It's an emphasis of the backbeat. The backbeat is the... it's the second beat in the vinyl. And it's... And it's emphasised in, probably in my case, but it's a sort of involuntary opening of the and closing of this thing, which is called the hi-hat. So that if you open it and close it very quickly, it goes... And that can emphasise this drum, which is called the snare drum. So if you... You can make it very loud if the two of them happen together, so... As opposed to... Normally, if you do a crash cymbal, it would be with either with a snare drum, because it's pathetic without it, or with a bass drum. This is actually a drum kit I've been using recently, which has sort of grown with me. This is mainly a Ludwig drum kit here, with these other things, you know, from the 70s, which are sort of rotor toms. They're tunable like this. And you can get very explosive sounds out. They can be very soft. They can have an explosive quality as well. Whereas opposed to these are more normal tom-toms, which are... So they're lower. It just gives me more range, you know.
For some reason, it works, the two of us, very well. When Roger and me play together, even now, somehow it has this broadness to it. And I think it's to do with the way he'll always hit his cymbals with something else. He'll always hit it absolutely perfectly with a bass drum or with a snare, the cymbals. And there's this kind of creamy texture to it. And Roger never plays anything without thought. It's never like just another yard of this. He's always thinking. He's always like putting some kind of expression in there. And it's amazing.